Hey guys, welcome to Traditional Bow Hunting and Wilderness Podcast. This is Jason Samkovic. Today we're going to talk about the proper way to hang and set. Key word being set. Tree stands today, especially if they are a friction or this style of a tree stand where they're not a ratchet strap or something that actually locks it to the tree. If they are a friction hold like you have on these Lone Wolf XOPs, Lone Wolf Customs, a lot of these tree stands that use this system, doesn't matter if you use one or two straps, we're going to cover that, but it's important that you set this and you set this stand correctly to be safe on it. Now, first thing is that we want to notice, see how this strap around this tree? On here, this stand is not set correct right now, but this strap is. See how I have that strap level, perpendicular, okay? If that strap were to be down here lower so that you had that and you try to cinch that stand in right there like this and you lock that in there, it's not even holding well, but if that were to set right there and you step on this because of that angle, this stand is going to do that and you're gonna fall. Okay, so you never want to have that. Now this angle here is not a horrible one, but there's still a lot of slack in that. So you want to set that with that strap perpendicular. You want that strap, so that strap's about perpendicular when you lock that to the tree. Okay, so that's number one rule. You want to have that set there and locked in. Now notice, if I take that, which we are a little above from where I'm seeing here, so that's perpendicular. So if I locked that at perpendicular, and I locked that with everything I got to lock that stand, that's on there, we're good, right? Wrong. That is not safe. If I were to put weight on this stand, it is going to shift down like that, right? And then if I step on this with my weight, what you're noticing is this back bracket back here, this V bracket, if I were to stand on this, that V bracket pulls away from the tree. Okay, that's not set. That bracket can pull away, and if I were to put all my weight on this and wiggle, I can actually knock that stand. Again, if I was standing on it, I could tip that stand right out of the way. It's not seated correctly. It's important that you seat the back of these stands. So if you look at that, and we put that on there, I'll show you a kind of a modified version here. So there it is, and we got it set right there, and it's on there. Now that's touching that. Give you, this is exaggerated slightly, but now if I were to leave that like that, and I were to just step on this stand, watch the back of that bat wing bracket, okay? And this happens quite often. Notice the space. I can actually run my hand behind this bracket back here, in that space. And I only have one hand on this. Imagine if I had all my weight on there. There's a lot of room there. That is unsafe. This stand can then tip again, can roll right out either direction. Okay, you don't want to have that. So it's important you start with that level, snug it down as tight as you can, and then you have to set the stand, seat the stand in there. So before you put on your lower strap or you want to set this, to set it, as you're standing here on your sticks with your lineman belt on, before you climb in, lift the platform base to release these lower teeth off of the tree, okay? Then push down on the stand to set that bat wing, to lock that in. Now that's locked, then while you're still applying pressure, cam this over, and you can see it even pull it more. Ready? Watch, I'll do that again, okay? So it's, here's where the stand sits normally when you hung it. There it is, tighten it on. I'm going to lift this here to remove this, so that's off. Push down on the stand to set the bat wing in the back, or the bracket that's in the back. Then while I'm there, watch as I cam this. It's going to pull it down even more, because these teeth on the bottom of the platform are going to bite the tree and help me pull it. Watch it come down more. See it seating? See it locking in there? Now that stand is officially locked in and jammed in there like I want and stable. That's what you want it to do. Okay, I hear people say, well, look, there's not a lot of tension on it when it's like that. That's okay, because all your tension is here and here. When you stand on this, that will eat that tension up, I promise you. But you want it like that. You don't want it to be, see, I can't even move it now because it's locked in there good like that. So if I release it a touch, put it back up, relock it. Okay, if you got that on there and those are tight like this, and they're good and tight, that means that you don't have this stand set. You want connection between the bat wing bracket on the back and the teeth of the platform. If this is like that, then right now with no weight on it, then it's not set good enough. You want that up, set in, and then you want to cam over and rock it down with the teeth. And when you do, now you notice these are looser because you have the tension here and here. That's what you're looking for. That sets the stand. Now if you're running two straps, now is the time you would put your second strap on there and lock that. If you lock that second strap before that, when it is in this position up here, and it is not cammed down, and you just have it on here, set, tighten down like this, and you put that strap on now, that you cannot do that set method in what you're going to, or if you have it tight, you can put it on but leave it loose. Because you need to be able to raise that platform and set that bat wing down by pushing down on there and then rolling that down to lock that in. You have to have that happen before you put that tension on that second strap. Otherwise, it will fight you. That will hold and this will pull away from the tree. By doing it the way I just showed you, that stand is set rock solid and not going to move and safe. And that bat wing behind here always stays to the tree. When I get on this stand, that will not move from there. Now, I purposely put this on an oak tree like this because it's got this real thick bark. On a pine tree, things like that, you're going to notice that it sets a lot easier. But when you get into trees like this that have got all these places that are going to bite these bottom teeth, you will soon realize that you're going to get that pull away from here unless you're setting it like I am right now. This method is what locks that in and gets it set good and safe for you. So it's, but you need to set that. Without setting it, you have no security on that stand. Again, if you're here, I'm going to pull it around this side so you can see it from a sideways view a little bit. But if you put that here like this and I tighten that on there, if I were to stand on this, that thing is pulling away. See that? Again, look at that. I can put my whole hand behind there. That is not safe. That means that this stand can roll or wobble at any time. If you were to lean out for a shot and step on this, that whole stand can twist and turn right out of there just like that because of the fact that you do not have that bat wing set. I cannot emphasize it enough. Very important that you do it the right way. So the method, you bring it on, you hook your strap around like this, you set your stand, crank it down with everything you got, tighten it on there. Once you do, grab the platform, put a hand here to push it down, lift to release that pressure on the back, set it. Set that bat wing down, then get here and then cam it right into the tree. Don't pull it out here and then turn it and lean it against there because that didn't do nothing. Watch right here. Now if I put it into the tree and roll it, you can see it pulling down on there and jams it right in. That's what you're looking for. That sets your stand and makes it safe and solid. So quick tip for you on how to do it. And you want to run two straps, run your second, but don't lock it till you have that stand set.